This conference will now be recorded.
Hi everyone, welcome to today's session. Today we are starting a new course which is highly in demand in the outside market. That is, we are going to start course on Python programming language. And as you are aware, in our channel we do have a videos related to SAP. Going forward I will be also making a videos on more trending technology in which it will help you guys to enhance your skill sets and help you to get a job outside. Okay, so as part of the series of videos, I will be taking you through entire Python programming language features and how to install different softwares, or what are the different software which you have to install in your laptop or desktop to learn the Python programming language. And also we will see, starting from very basics to write a very simple Python program till the complex program. And in the process of that, we will keep learning the additional concept or few important concept which will make us to become at least the Python developer who is having average or above average knowledge. Okay, so that is the intention of this course. And I will make sure that videos are crisp and clear, and so that you guys will be able to utilize your less time and learn more info as part of these videos. So let's start. So as you are aware, why we have chosen Python language, or why I as a SAP developer or SAP lead consultant who is into SAP ABAP, BWAP, and HANA, I have got an interest in learning Python. So just to give a summary, why anybody in this technological era we have to go for Python language? Because Python is a general purpose language. So as the name indicates, it's a very general purpose language. It is very easy to learn and which can be used in n number of applications, be it from starting from simple normal academic programming language learning purpose to implementation of your artificial intelligence algorithm or machine learning algorithm. Okay, the application of Python language is very vast. That's why it is general purpose language. And coming to the next point, we also use Python for web development. There is some new concept or new profile or job profile which is being created in the recent days, like a full stack developer. Correct? So using Python language, you can implement that full stack development implementations. And we also use Python for data analysis purpose. That is, for example, for your predictive analytics, analyze your data and see the trends and stuff like that. So we can also use Python programming language to implement the logic related to Internet of Things. As you are aware, Internet of Things is one of the happening stuff in 21st century. I can say by 2020 or by 2022, it is expected more than 40 billion sensors will be connected to internet, and there will be large pool of data which is fed to your server. That data can be used and analyzed using Python easily. If you know the basic of Python, you can make use of existing libraries and you can build the amazing applications. And coming to the next application, scientific computing. This particular Python programming language coming to other important aspect of Python application is artificial intelligence, and this is most happening stuff in our 21st century. So as you are aware, you can build a more and more complex algorithm to make your system artificially intelligent. And further, you can also use this particular programming language for even implementation of machine learning concepts. Clear? So this is why I choose to learn or upgrade my skill with Python. So I hope you guys agree with me. Coming to the next topic, we are going to learn Python language features as part of this session. So as any other programming language, for example, C, C++, Java, each and every programming language has its own feature. Because of that, it has attracted many developers towards it, right? So similar to that, we do have language features or some important factors related to Python programming language. We'll see that in a while. So as you can see, the very first topic with respect to our very first item with respect to Python language feature is easy to learn and use. As Python is very easy to learn and use, it's a developer friendly and a high level programming language. As it says, it is very user friendly language. You don't have to remember the syntax. The syntax of the language is very in plain English. Okay, anybody can understand. The second point also says the same. It's an expressive language. Python language is more expressive, means it is more understandable and readable. The syntax of this Python programming language is almost similar to native English language, which we use for day-to-day communication. So it is more expressive. So even if somebody who is not a Python developer, who is not having Python technical knowledge, can easily see and read the code and understand what is happening over there. And the Python is interpreted language. Mean to say, Python is an interpreted language, that is, interpreter executes the code line by line at a time. This makes debugging easy and thus suitable for beginners. So this means the interpretation of the Python code will be happening by the compiler line by line, one line at a time. Okay, so that you can keep a breakpoint and you can also see what is the state of your variable at each and every stage of your program execution. Okay, and since this is a line by line executed or interpreted language, using debugger, the beginners can easily understand. And Python is also a cross-platform language. You might have already aware what is cross-platform. So Python can run equally on different platforms such as Windows, Linux, Unix, Macintosh. Mean to say, you develop a Python application on Windows machine, you can easily just copy paste the code. If the Python is already installed on Mac machine or Linux machine, you can run the code without even minor change in the code. So it is portable or cross-platform language. Clear? So these are the few features. Let's see additional feature of the Python programming language. The next item is Python is free and open source. Entire Python language is freely available in the official website, which is python.org, which is free to download. And since it's an open source, there are a lot of community built across, and you will get a lot of support also, since it is very famous nowadays. And Python can also support object-oriented language. Python is a sequential language and also it's an object-oriented language too. Mean to say, the object-oriented concept like class and method will also applicable over here, right? And large standard library is being provided or supported by Python. Python has large and broad library which provide rich set of modules and functions for rapid application development. Mean to say, in Python, there are a couple of communities, and even Python itself as a language provide lot of standard libraries. You can just make use of those libraries or reuse those libraries and develop your application very fast. You don't have to develop everything from the scratch. For everything, you have a library provided. For example, there is a library given by SAP for your graphical user interface creation. You just have to call the method and pass the parameter to that. There is something like SPICY for all your scientific calculation, or you can make use of that. There is some even other IoT related libraries given. You name it, for everything there is already an existing library. All you have to do is you have to reuse the same. So coming to the next point, GUI programming support. As I said just now, graphical user interface can be developed using Python. Okay, so there are existing library, you can make use of that, or else you can build your entire GUI from the very scratch. Okay, so that you can create standalone desktop application too. And Python is an integrated, means it can be easily integrated with other languages like C, C++, Java. Assume that you are developing a complex application which is making use of multiple languages, okay, which involves multiple languages. So part of the application is developed in C, part of it is being developed in Java, and part it has to be developed in Python. So based on your business requirement or based on your application performance point of view, if Python suits over there, you can implement the particular module using Python, and then you can integrate with other language modules too. So that's the reason, these are the main language features of Python. That's the reason I have choose to upgrade my skill with Python. I hope this video will help you guys to understand the important language features of Python, and also why I have chosen Python language to learn at this point of stage in my career. And that's all with respect to this session. In the upcoming session, I will also take you through what are the different necessary software to be present in your laptop or desktop, or which you have to install to start your Python journey. That's all with respect to this session. Thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel. And for any online training related stuff, you can always reach out to me on my mail ID, that is venugopalmn1988@gmail.com. And you can also reach me on my mobile number, which will be there in my other videos. Thank you so much, and have a good one. Happy learning.